morning, everyone. This is a very big hello from Cairo. I am Maissa Shawky. I am the Deputy Minister of Health for Population, and I'm in charge of two very important and delicate councils here in Egypt, the National Population Council and the National Council for Childhood and Motherhood. Hi, Ignacio, and it's a very big hello. I missed the opportunity to meet you all. I've been overscheduled for the first couple of weeks in February, and I couldn't make it. Maybe very soon we are going to meet. I'm happy to share with you our interventions that we are doing here in Egypt as regards the population and the childhood and motherhood with the family nested in between. As we have communicated together, Ignacio and myself, we are speaking about five main domains that it would be great to share it with you, maybe to get a feedback. And on the other hand, it's very possible that you find what we are doing here in Egypt as being so good to be replicated elsewhere. First, I would like to talk about the National Plan for Community and Health Awareness. It's being issued by the National Population Council, and it is meant to deliver very simplified messages that are core and important for the health and community development. Our plan, our national plan, is layered into six layers to reach the population, and at the very end to induce a real change in the knowledge, attitude, and the behaviors of the public, and of course with expected and measured outcomes at the very end. We had to work as a team in the Population Council, and we had to prioritize our topics or the domains of which we are going to hold tight during the transmission of these messages. As you can see, we have four portfolios, and we have 31 topics that are meant to be important by virtue of indicators here in Egypt, whether they are health or social indicators. We have four training portfolios. These portfolios have been scientifically prepared by a very highly selected team, and they are adjusted to be delivered to the community. And we put in mind very clearly that we have a good majority of our population as being of low level of education or of financial limitations at their very delicate homes. So we've customized this, and we've made it simple to be understood and simple to be implemented or doable in other terms. Our plan is to work our four training portfolios to in a form of a TOT and then reach the community. This is what we call the direct approach. What about the indirect approach? Our plan is meant to be having two pathways to be delivered. One of them is indirect and the other is a direct one. In the indirect one, we have community mobilized experts from the different domains related to the population issues. And we've named them as a group the ambassadors of the National Population Council in the community. We conducted with them several workshops to have it settled what is it that they have to deliver to the community, which kind of language, and what are the messages. And we are mounting them into the media, into the television and the radio, into the talk shows in particular, and they are enacting this right now. Instead of working on delivering TV spots, for example, which are very costly in their development and they are very costly in their airing time as well, we had to find our way to do more delivering of the message itself and more contact time with our audience. So through the indirect route, we have television and we have the radio as a media, and we have the newspapers, and we consider that in radio and in the media, in the television and in the radio, we have very simplified messages, and we give it a bigger scientific breath when it is on the newspapers. We call the first group the ambassadors of the Population Council in the media. Next pathway is to deliver our messages in a form that is direct face-to-face. This is more costly, and it's a little bit more difficult to implement, and it is difficult also to reach your hardcore people. So we had to have a look on the population pyramid. and check how we are going to do it. Within this, we have the University Pioneers. This is a TOT program. It's a peer-to-peer program. We train a number of students through communicating with the Ministry of Higher Education. We have 24 national universities in Egypt cooperating with us, and we are working on two stages, 12 universities to be followed by another 12. And as you see, we have very informative pictures of how students can be cooperative with us, and they are also, on the other hand, they feel self-actualized, they feel very happy to deliver, they feel very happy also about their positivity. Next, we have an implementation plan for our awareness in schools, for students and for parents as well. And we are working actually in the ground in 86 spots in Egypt, all over Egypt, mobilizing also our ambassadors and mobilizing university students and school teachers to work with us in the community in 86 spots. And we call these 86 spots, the 86 red spots in Egypt. I'll be moving to my next point. It is about the evidence-based atlas for population development. And as you can see, the atlas on the screen, this atlas is based on scientific research. It is a composite indicators research. It has a number of simple direct indicators to be completed to 64. Indicators when it is being manipulated or it's being used through a certain statistical equation. We meant to have a mean at the very end of these 64 indicators. They are population and demographic indicators. And we ranked all over Egypt how would the picture look like. Someone would ask, what are the sources of information? Where did you bring those 64 indicators from? I would say we have the Demographic and Health Survey for the year 2014, and we have the Human Development Report for 2010. We have the annual data from the CAPMAS, or the Central Agency for National Information in Egypt. And we also have our outlets to collect the data. We have 27 centers, one in each governorate, and we can bring our local data by hand. When these indicators were mixed together, we got a picture of Egypt that is very important for all of us to share. As you can see, we have color-coded or traffic light color codes distribution for our governorates. We have 9 red in color, 9 yellow, and 9 are green. The red ones are to be prioritized as the most in need for conducting population development. Homeworks by the different ministries, of course. And when we reach another slide, you are going to find that we have the 86 red spots on board, and these are the locations where we have to work for intensified face-to-face approach. So how can we work if we are to understand that the population development in Egypt works through the governorates in a decentralized fashion? A fully empowered governor is to have his population atlas in hand and to have a look on the map for his own governorate. And he has also another tool to use, that's an implementation table. I'm going to put for you Kafr Sheikh as a governorate. Kafr Sheikh, its location is in Lower Egypt. And it has the red spots demarcating where the illegal migration is happening in our country. And as you can see, it is red colored and is more to the north towards the Mediterranean Sea. This is where we have to work, but sometimes it's not enough to look at the map and then start doing your homework. If we move to the next slide, it is the implementation table for one and the same governorate, that is Kafr Sheikh. And you can find towards the right a little bit, we have the different districts, and they are also color-coded. And towards the left, we have the interventions that should be implemented by the different ministries. Some of them are for health, some of them are for the infrastructure, the water supply and the sewage disposal, some of them are for schools and its availability, and alike. You can find infant mortality, you can find maternal mortality, coverage by health services. All of these are very sensitive tools as indicators for the different ministerial implementation. If we can go a little bit more, our work is delivered by a peripheral decentralized body. It's a board, it's a peripheral board, and this peripheral board would include representatives from all ministries, and they have to do their homework, but we are helping them to prioritize. This has been delivered to all governors, and it's also implemented to the cabinet, and it's currently being used as a prioritization tool. I'm attaching for you also along my email a full version of the Population Development Atlas because it is useful to review our different governorates and its pattern. Next, I'll be moving to the third topic on my email, Ignacio. That's about the National Strategy for Childhood and Motherhood. The NCCM, or the National Council for Childhood and Motherhood, was lacking a platform to work from, a missing strategy for children and mother has been a serious problem, and right now we are finished with its early draft. It will be disseminated during February, and we are having a celebration and an event for it. It is based upon child rights. It is stakeholders oriented. We all shared in developing of this strategy, and also children did share. What's more important is that we have a forum for children that's been elected or interviewed from all over the 27 governorates. Represented in it are the normal children, children with disabilities, children whom we call the parentless or the orphan children. We have full representation of children in children's forum, and we have also another network for child protection from the children, especially so in Upper Egypt. They disseminate child's rights, and they report to the child helpline any kind of violation of child's rights. Let me move with you to what do we mean by child helpline. We have three helplines in the National Council for Childhood and Motherhood. The most important is the child helpline. It is 16000. And we have a family helpline. This is a very important one. It's for family counseling. It discusses, of course, the reproductive health and family planning and all issues about parenting and positive parenting. Has been recently added upon this line. Its number is 16021-16021. And we have a third very important line that's for children with disabilities, for the children themselves and for their families. And right now we are socially marketing for them, and they are being greatly used. The helpline for children with disabilities is 0800-38888 and 466666. All the lines are being used. We do some analysis for the lines. They can give us a very rich and wealthy information. Next, I'm moving to the support. We have a campaign in Egypt. I wouldn't miss that. And as you can see, this campaign is about positive parenting, something that we really found is missing as an essence in our country. And it is a combined collaboration between National Council for Childhood and Motherhood, UNICEF, and it is funded by the EU. And this campaign has been implemented or has been launched in Egypt 1 month ago. And accordingly, we have 60 million viewers on the social media. It is disseminated in 19 governorates. We have 181 billboards in 19 governorates. And we have 500 million printouts. And as you can see, these printouts are being disseminated in lots of outlets here in Egypt. It's because the research prior to this campaign, we found that families don't know about how they are actually violating child's rights, and it was important to pinpoint the important violations and to dispense it as well, and it is being aired on the television. support for families with handicapping comes next, with disabilities, I'm sorry, comes next. We do community dialogues, and as you can see on our PowerPoint presentation, meeting with families is very important to be able to inspire their problems and to reach how we can help them, whether this is related to health, whether this is related to education, it's related to social support. They need whatever their needs are. We cannot detect the needs unless we are doing research and we are doing a direct face-to-face dialogues. And as you see, we did meet a lot families for children with disabilities, and out of that we reached that we have to help these families know where the rights are from the different ministries. And right now we are working, this is the second photo I'm putting for you. It's where we brought up on board in a roundtable discussion and a closed workshop, we brought representatives from different ministries, and we asked them to script out and write all the services provided available at their destiny for children with disabilities. And we also had on board NGOs as representatives of this community serving children with disabilities. And right now we are exercising, and homework is to deliver for them a booklet that tells them what about services available for them, where is its location in each governorate, how to contact the ministry representatives, what are the phone calls and numbers, is there an email available, what kind of paper documents they have to take with them to reach for the service in and any ministerial outlet in each governorate. We are working on this right now. It should be delivered by next March. We do have a fund account. We have a fund account for children and mothers, and we have a fund account to be raised by His Excellency President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi very, very soon for children with disabilities. Let me tell you that we also moving to what interventions are we doing on the ground. We have an intervention that is very important. It's called Our Community is Egyptian. It has been pre-tested in two governorates. These two governorates were Upper Egypt governorates. Our Community is Egyptian is an intervention where we settle down in the villages that need population development. We call for the people to come and listen and work with us in a team. We have the adolescents, we have the youth, we have the older generations, we have mothers, we have children. They all come on board, and we start to teach them to map their own community, and to map their community, define their problems, prioritize these problems, and start solving them through an intervention that's more or less like coaching. And we have, together with us, NGOs, to learn the process itself. One of the interventions was family dialogue between husband and wife to reduce conflicts within the families and to help them to listen to each other and understand that there should be common grounds. This would reduce the family disintegration and would reduce the cases of divorce very much. We also have training for religious key peoples from Islamic religion and Christianity. They sit together under one and the same roof, and they listen to the population messages that we want. And it is very enough that in our community people find representatives of the two religions in one class and hand in hand together in the community. We also speak about leadership and priority setting very much. We listen to adolescents in their classes because they attend sessions for very delicate problems in Egypt, like anti-FGM, anti-female genital mutilation, and they listen to sessions that are early marriage or childhood marriage. And from this, we talk to adolescent boys and girls, we talk to youth, we talk to mothers and grandmothers and grandfathers, we talk to the whole community in a face-to-face. And as you can see, that our pictures are very illustrative of how we reach for the people in the community. Right now, population issues, the population dynamics and the population problem is having very great attention, very high political advocacy. Our president is into it every day on the media and in the newspapers, looking at the population as a wide paradigm and having the family in the very center, the family support at the very center, the prevention of the breaking down of families, whether in family conflicts or or in divorce situations is currently a top priority in our country. I hope I'm not very much talkative, and I hope you also enjoy my PowerPoint presentation. This is the best of what I can do, and I hope to see you soon. Thank you very much.